When Vic was little, he was brought up in the army. And in the army camp, he'd made a little theater. And he had a monkey, a bear, and a dog with one ear. And he would make a story inside this little theater for the soldiers to see. And every time it was different. And I said, I rang him one day, because he was at home because he wasn't well enough to get up. Oh, I don't know what to do next. I don't know. And then he told me this story. I said, that's fantastic. And so I began to do, I did that story. But then, of course, the people, the monkey and the bear and the dog that were near became people I knew. You know, it always happens. All these animals become people I know. And the thing becomes rather personal, really. So I was able to, because if you make them into animals, you do anything, can't you?
Like the girl and the dog.
Like the girl and the dog. And the dog was because of Vic. Oh. It was just looking after Vic. Oh. Because he was very sick then. And again, a friend said, Colette said, why don't you do something about Vic? And I thought, well, okay. Well, then I thought, well, a girl and a dog, you see. Because you see, like the dog, when you open a dog's, when you feed medicine into a dog, you have to open his mouth by force, like this, and then put in the medicine. And I thought there's both, there's tenderness, there's curing, there's tenderness, and there's aggression. And because, you know, holding the mouth open is aggressive and so I thought that all those things together were like what it was like at the time, you see. Because there are so many mixed feelings about somebody who's very ill. You no matter how much you love them, you resent them dreadfully for being ill. And you want to care for them. Anyway, it was what I did, was the girls and dogs was all that big. And then I led on to other things and so on. And in the meantime, I met Rudy Nassauer, who became a very, very good friend and was an immense help to me. Because first of all, he took me to Italy to look at proper art. Not just the one in the National Gallery, to Florence, to Venice, and so on, to look at a real thing. And he said, listen, you must stop buggering around. I mean, you must stop just fooling around. You must just work, just work. And I did. And he was a very, very strong, influence, a bit of a bully, but that's what I needed. He was good.
He was fantastic at arguing and being passionate about his points of view.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
But I remember when you were at the National Gallery, that wonderful picture, right, that you did of him in the Jacob.
Yeah, screen. That was to bring him into the limelight, you see. I did when, because he was, it was a relationship which was like, you know, I'm not married to Rudy, he's my friend, but I thought, but he needs, it was a homage to him. And it was a homage to Rudy to bring him, put him in a picture of, it was Joseph sleeping. And it was after Philippe Champagne. And I did, and he sat for me several times, and I did drawings of him, and I put him in this picture. And I did, and he wasn't just the bear, he was now the man. Mm-hmm. You see, I'd stopped him being an animal and put him into a man. And then he was out, it was, you know, shown. So that was good.